All right, I'd like to continue talking about the subset sums problem. And now I'm finally at the dynamic programming implementation of this problem. So to make things concrete, let's have three items, W1, W2, W3. And let me just make the weights be 1, 2, and 3 so that everything is very simple. And my upper bound on the weights that I'm allowed to have, let's say, is just 5. Sure, just 5. Okay, so let us trace through this algorithm right here to see the dynamic programming approach. The first thing that we have to do is we're going to create an array with n plus 1 rows and w plus 1 columns. So the rows go from 3 down to 0, 3, 2, 1, 0. That'll be my rows. And the columns go from 0 up to 5. Okay. Okay, the first thing I do is initialize the 0th row to have all elements 0 in it. Okay, so that takes care of that. Let me draw some grid lines here so that it might be a little easier to follow along. Okay, next we are going to go from I goes from 1 to 2, and so we'll be modifying the ith row. See here where I'm making the calculation m of i something. So we are calculating our m of iw element. So we're going through the I rows right here, i and w. Okay, so we start with I is 1 and w starts at 0. So I'm going to the 1, 0 row, this one right here. And in fact, we'll be filling them in row major order. So I won't need to mark it off anymore like that. Okay, so W equals 0. Now I take W is 0 less than W of 1. And the answer is yes, it is. So I just compute W of 1, 0 is assigned the value W of 0, 0. Okay, then I increment my W. And I ask, is 1 less than w sub 1? And the answer to that is no, they are equal. So here I need to compute my 1 element by choosing the max between these two things right here. So let me just write those two things down so that I can see them. So that's the max 0, 1. M of 0, 1 is 0. Or W1, which is 1, plus M of 0, W minus 1, so that's 1 minus 1 gives us 0. This is M0, 0, 0. M0, 0, 0 is 0, so that's 1 plus 0. The max of those two things is 1, so that is assigned to our current location right there. Okay, W goes to 2. So I have, is 2 less than 1? And the answer is no. So now I need to compute the max of, I'm going to write it out this time so I don't get less confused. 1 minus 0 is 0. And W is 2. Or W1, which is 1, plus M of 0. And 2 minus 1 gives us 1. Okay, this number right here, M02, is 0. M01 is 0. So I have 1 plus 0, and that gives me 1. So max between 0 and 1 gives me 1. Okay, W goes to 3. And I'm going to choose between, let's see, so 3 is not less than 1, so I'll make my assignment to 1, 3 is the max of M, 0, 3. 0, 3 is 0. Or W sub 1, which is 1, plus M of 0, and this is 3 minus 1 gives us 2. Okay, 0, 2 gives us 0, so it's 1 plus 0. So the max between 0 and 1 is 1. Okay. Then W goes to 4. So 4 is not less than 1. So here's my assignment. I have to find the max between M of 0, 4, or W sub 1 plus M of 0, 4 minus 1 is 3. So this 0, 4 is 0. Actually, 0, anything is 0. So it's 0 or 1 plus 0 gives us the max of those two is 1. Okay, W goes to 5. And I'm going to choose between the max. So this test fails, so I'll make my assignment by choosing the max between these two things. M of 0, 5. Or 1 plus M of 0, 5 minus 1 is 4. So that gives me 1. Okay, so now I'm ready. Let's see, I need to increment my I. My I now goes to 2, so I'll be filling in the 2 row. My W starts at 0. Is 2 less than 2? W sub 2 is 2. Yes, it is. So here's my computation. My M of 2 comma 0 equals my M of 1 comma 0. So this has the value 2. Okay, increment my W. Is 1 less than 2? Yes, it is. So my M of 2 comma 1 equals M of 1 comma 1. So this equals 1. 2 comma 1 equals 1 comma 1. So it's going like so. Okay, increment my W. Is 2 less than 2? No, it isn't. So my M of 2 comma 2 is going to be the max of these two things. So it'll be the max of M of 1, I minus 1 is 2 minus 1 is 1, comma W, which is 2, or W sub 2, which is 2, plus M of 2 minus 1 is 1, and 2 minus W sub 2 is 0. Okay, so M12 has a value 1, and M10 has a value 0. So I'm choosing between 1, 0, 1 or 2, so the answer is 2, so that's what I've got right there. Okay, W goes to 3 now. So let's see, 3, is that less than 2? No, it is not. So M23 will be assigned the value, the max of these two things. M of 1, I minus 1, comma W, which is 3. Or the weight, if I include the ith element there, which is 2, right? W sub 2 is 2, plus M of 2 minus 1 is 1, and then 3 minus 2 is 1. Okay, M13 is 1. M11 is 1. So I'll be choosing between 1 or 2 plus 1 gives me 3, so that'll be 3. Okay, W goes to 4. Okay, so is 4 less than 2? No, it isn't. So M24 will be assigned the max of these two things, M of 1 comma 4, or W sub 2 plus M of 1 comma 4 minus 2 is 2. 1, 4 is 1. This goes to 1. 1, 2, 1, 2 is 1. So that's 1 versus 2 plus 1 is 3. Take the 3. Okay, W5. Let's see, 5 less than 2? Nope. So M of 2, 5 will be the max of these two things. So that is M of 1 comma 5, or 2 plus M of 1 comma 5 minus 2 is 3. Okay, 1, 5, has, 1, 5 has a value 1, and 1, 3 has a value 1. So max of 1 or 2 plus 1 gives us 3. Okay, let's erase the unnecessary stuff and continue on with my next outer loop. Do it this way this time, huh? Okay, so I now goes to 3. W starts at 0. Okay, so I'm looking at weight 3. So is 3 less than 0 less than 3? Yes, it is. So M of 3, 0 equals M of 2, 0. So this goes to 0. Increment my W. Okay, is 1 less than 3? Yes, it is. So M of 3, 1 equals M of 2, 1. It's 1. Okay, increment W. Is 2 less than 3? Yes, it is. So M of 3, 2 equals M of 2, 2. So that's 2 right there. Okay, increment my W. Is 3 less than 3? Nope. So M of 3, 3, that's that element right there, will be the max between M of 2, 3. And W3, which is 3, plus M of 2, W minus W3, which is 0. Okay, M of 2, 3 has the value 3. M of 2, 0 has the value 0. Max between 0 and 3 plus 0 gives us 3. Okay, W to 4. 4 is not less than 3, so I'll do this right here. So I'm going to choose between the max of these two things, M of 2, 4, or 3 plus M of, this is 2, and 4 minus 3 is 1. Okay, 2, 4 has the value 3. 2, 1. M of 2, 1 has the value 1. So I choose max between 3 and 3 plus 1 gives me 4. I want the 4. Okay, W5. 5 is not less than 3. So I'm right here for my very last statement. So I'll choose between the max of M of 2, comma 5, or 3 plus M of 2, comma, 5 minus 3 is 2. So 2, 5 is 3. 2, 2. 2, 2 is 2. So I'm choosing, the max of 3 or 3 plus 2 is 5. Okay, now's the test of the pudding. This right here is my solution for maximizing the weights of finding a subset of these three items, 3, 2, or 1, any subset right here. And the maximum weights I can come up with is 5. And I found right here that I have a solution where the total maximum weights is 5, so that matches right there. And if I were to go back to see where that came from, you would see that I could get that by choosing number 3, right? And then I can choose number 2, item 2. So that would be 3 plus 2 gives me my 5. Okay, so I choose item 3 and then item 2, and I'm done. Okay, so the solution, we'll do the backtrace in a later talk, but the solution is going to be choosing item 3 and item 2. And the weight is 5. So that's a demonstration of the dynamic programming implementation of finding the subset sums.